Well, they do, and I think Dr. Jackman could speak to the specifics about this, but let me make a general comment first. You know, the idea about targeted therapy is that you have a drug that interacts specifically with the abnormal protein that's caused by this gene mutation. You know, genes don't do anything themselves. Genes are the blueprints for proteins, and it's proteins that cause most of the abnormalities we're talking about. And these drugs, if they're designed right, will bind to the abnormal protein to turn off its effects and not to the normal. So the basis for side effects is the drugs that we use inhibit normal proteins. So this theoretical drug shouldn't interact with the normal protein. And to some extent, the BRAF inhibitor is kind of like that. And so we're seeing many, many fewer side effects, and certainly not the nausea, vomiting, hair loss, low blood count sort of side effects. Other things, skin rash, and in the BRAF inhibitor thing, occasionally some skin cancers that can be treated locally. But the spectrum is quite different. But you're actually practicing this and seeing these differences.
Many of the targeted therapies have been considerably more tolerable than how we traditionally think of chemotherapy, but do want to be clear and careful about recognizing that they still are chemotherapies, they still are drugs that have the potential for side effects. And so just because something is a pill per se, not to equate it to aspirin. You know, that there are potentially significant side effects that we want to warn patients about, educate them to recognize, and as we as a community get more familiar with how to recognize and treat these things, we're all getting better at it.